Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to our 2021 annual community meeting. My name is Paul Gillum, and I have the privilege of working in the Halliburton, Kawartha, Pine Ridge, and Durham communities as executive director. And this is my co-host, Jeff Curry.
Hi, everyone. I am honored to be here today to help co-host.
This is our sixth annual general meeting and the second time that we're doing this virtually. Jeff and I would like to open by acknowledging the Indigenous peoples of all the lands that we are on today. We are coming to you from Peterborough, the traditional territory of the Anishinaabe people. While we meet virtually today, we acknowledge the importance of the lands that we call home, and we affirm our commitment and responsibility to improve relationships between nations and our own understanding of local Indigenous people and their cultures. From coast to coast to coast, we acknowledge the ancestral and unceded territory of the Inuit, Métis, and First Nations people. Please join us in a moment of reflection as we acknowledge the harms of the past, many of which were done in the name of Christianity, and consider how we can work together to move forward in the spirit of truth and reconciliation. Thank you. Everyone who attends this year's ACM will be entered into a draw to win one of our amazing limited edition Hope in Action swag bags. Not only are these bags full of creative and beautiful things to enjoy, but all items have also been made and sold to us by people supported in the Central East District. We have some amazing artists and entrepreneurs here, and we wanted to be able to showcase some of their amazing talent. Can you come and look? I can't seem to find it there. So someone's going to help for a moment here. When we met at our annual community meeting last year, I remember feeling hopeful that the pandemic was, for the most part, in our rearview mirror. Yet here we are, and we've been hit by a third and fourth wave. I'm sure each of you, though, would agree that this past year has been difficult. However, through it all, we have seen rays of hope. And that is why we made our theme this year, Hope in Action, Communities Where Everybody Belongs. We have been and will continue to take action to work towards a better tomorrow where everybody is valued, have opportunities to contribute, and experience belonging in our communities. We believe that the future of our communities and each of our fellow citizens looks bright. As a service provider, one of the reasons we are excited about the future is our province's vision for developmental services reform. They call it Journey to Belonging, Choice, and Inclusion. In that document, they state that they want to see communities where people with developmental disabilities are able to thrive and participate fully in their communities. If you have not had an opportunity to read that plan, I encourage you to look at their website. It's very, very exciting. Those of you who use our services, you have continued to learn and make significant choices this past year. We have seen your resilience, perseverance, and excitement for the future. And that also gives us hope. One of the important relationships as we do our work at Christian Horizons is the relationship that we have with our government. And I would like to introduce Tasha Ullman. Tasha is our local program supervisor from the Ministry of Children, Community and Social Services. And she is bringing us greetings on behalf of the ministry and the provincial government.
Thanks, Paul. As Paul mentioned, I'm in attendance this afternoon representing the Ministry of Children, Community and Social Services as the program supervisor for Christian Horizons Central East District. I feel fortunate to be a part of this event as you take an opportunity to pause and reflect on all the successes that you have accomplished collectively in the last year, and also take account of lessons learned to inform your future steps with much hope and anticipation. The commitment, responsiveness, and adaptability that has been demonstrated by the leadership team and staff at Christian Horizons has been instrumental in ensuring continuity of quality services in this district, as well as maintaining a safe environment for supported individuals and their families, despite all the twists and turns that we have experienced in light of the pandemic. On behalf of the ministry, I would like to extend our sincere gratitude to the dedicated board members of Christian Horizons, senior leadership and management teams, and staff of the organization, particularly those who work in the Central East District, as well as the individuals and families who are in receipt of supports and services from Christian Horizons. As the ministry endeavors to reform developmental services over the next 8 to 10 years, we look forward to our continued partnership with Christian Horizons and those in receipt of these services to accomplish a vision of empowerment, independence, flexibility, and inclusivity for supported individuals with a developmental disability. Again, I thank the Central East District for hosting this event today to celebrate your successes and greatly applaud you on behalf of the ministry for your passion, innovation, and positive contributions to the community. Thank you.
Board of directors are called to govern the ministry of our organization. We are deeply grateful for this dedicated group of volunteers who are committed to our values and vision and ensure we stay on track to achieve our. Mission, Rick Elliott will now bring us greetings from the board.
Hello, greetings. And welcome to your 2021 annual community meeting celebrating this ministry, the accomplishments of Christian Horizons in your district, and above all else, celebrating you, those individuals supported by Christian Horizons, staff, and senior leadership. My name is Rick Elliott, and I am honored to be the current chair of the Christian Horizons Board of Directors. I've been a board member for approximately 10 years, and it has been such a blessing to be a part of this wonderful organization. Although unable to be with you in person today, we are grateful for technology that provides the opportunity for me to bring you virtual greetings and yes, even some virtual hugs on behalf of the entire board. Your board of directors consists of a terrific group of dynamic individuals who volunteer their time and skills to provide leadership and oversight to the work and ministry of Christian Horizons. Our directors come from all walks of life. We have medical professionals, pastors, educators, financial experts, and business people. A number of board members have served for many, many years. And for three of our directors, this is their first year on the board, and we warmly welcome them. What all have in common is their love of those served by Christian Horizons and the common belief in the values, vision, and mission of this very special organization. Over many decades now, Christian Horizons has been of service to hundreds of individuals with special needs here in Ontario and more recently in Saskatchewan. In addition, Christian Horizons has a significant global outreach to a number of countries including Haiti, Ethiopia, Guatemala, and others, where our organization works with partners to improve the lives of those with disabilities in these impoverished countries, providing safe places and inclusiveness where people who experience disabilities belong to those communities in which their God-given gifts are valued and respected, as stated in our vision statement. To each and every one of you supported by Christian Horizons in any way, we want you to know how truly and highly valued you are, and what wonderful and important contributions you make to your various communities. And to all of the Christian Horizons staff, direct support workers, supervisors, district managers, head office staff, senior leadership team, and our CEO, Janet, we thank God for all of you and your dedication, hard work, and love of what you do and those who are served. This past year has again been extremely challenging as we continue to be impacted by a pandemic that frustratingly does not want to give up easily. As a result, there continue to be ongoing changes in the way Christian Horizons operates in order to do whatever possible and necessary to protect the health and safety of everyone. But you have in the past and continue to accept these challenges and have demonstrated the theme for 2021, that regardless of the challenges, you are demonstrating hope in action to continue to provide communities where everybody belongs. Prayerfully, when we meet again next year, COVID-19 will be a thing of the past and we will have returned to some sense of normalcy. Enjoy this day of celebrating your successes over the past year. You have certainly earned it. Thank you for your time, and may God richly bless you and your families. Have a wonderful meeting.
Thank you, Rick.
At this time, we would like to share a video with you about experiences with quite a few people who use our services and had this past year. It was anything but easy, and yet through the amazing support from our staff, teams, people have continued to have hope and live meaningful lives.
Through these stories, we see examples of our onward strategic plan in action. People are experiencing our core values. People are directing their own choices. People are experiencing growth and development, and people are experiencing communities of belonging. All of these things happened this past year, even through COVID.
In 2020, we saw our strategic plan in action. Here are a few stories that show people who use Christian Horizons services putting hope in action this year.
In the previous year, we were setting goals for the upcoming year. Fraser had wanted to go parachuting, so we had the idea of contacting the iFly, which is like an indoor kind of skydiving experience.
Harold, pretty much every day of the week, he was out in the community doing something.
Get ready. I get out early in the morning. We get ready to get lunch. We're making lunch, guys. Ready to go.
We were out for a walk with Mustafa, Kyle, and Harold, and it was a track. Mustafa actually went faster around the track. I thought, well, if he likes to go faster, let's try this as a sport.
Do you like running?
Running.
Were you happy?
Happy.
Good job.
I was working at Pizza Pizza here in Thorold. That was a job that I enjoyed doing, and I had some other volunteer work.
I'm going to be there for her no matter what. Whatever it takes, she's number one to me. You know, and I named her Heaven because of that. And here she is, a beautiful baby.
And then all of a sudden, COVID hit. I think there was an anxiety for him because things aren't open right now. Like the iFly isn't open right now. We had been watching YouTube videos of skydiving, and I mean, Fraser would just beam when he watched these videos. And of course, that's when Jody came on the scene. And at his COVID check-in, she heard about his goals and she said, "Have you heard of the Oculus?" And we jumped on it. So the Oculus did provide a very good source of entertainment for him, so it was definitely helpful.
How's that? Good, she find myself.
You're a daredevil, hey? Just be honest.
When he saw the image, like at first it was like this look of shock. And then all of a sudden it was like ear to ear smile. Like, and then the next thing we knew, his hands were in the air. And he's so he really did like enjoy the full experience. I mean, what started as parachuting has morphed into now, like he goes to theme parks on his Oculus and does roller coasters, and he's done space exploration, he's done scuba diving, he's watched live concerts. We even had an Elvis concert and he was amazed. What started as this one goal has now turned into him accomplishing all these things that he didn't even like think were possible.
I've supported Harold for about 7 years, and I think it was the first time I ever seen him not attend work. He stopped work, stopped church, all the day programs closed. Basically, everything stopped.
I write Saturday, over at 12:33.
It was very difficult for him to understand. He was so used to spending weekends with his family and at their house. We talked about how he could video chat. And so started using Facebook to video chat his sister. We used to arrange it that like the staff would come and assist him to call and assist him to hang up. And then one day they walked by and he was just on the phone with his sister. And so that was really exciting because his iPad's always in his room. He always has internet access. He was able just to, whenever he felt like it, call his sister. And then through that, he connected with Robert, who is the son of the host family that he lived with for many, many years. From there, Robert's sister has contacted Harold. Robert's aunts have contacted Harold.
Michelle, Robert, Michelle, my granddad, my brother. And then Teresa, you know, oh, my sister's DT. I gotta call DT.
It's very disappointing when we couldn't do what we normally did before COVID. I was in his room one day and I saw these medals on his wall, and he has this big poster of him with the medal, and he was a swimmer and he was like the poster boy for Special Olympics. So I said, wow, you already have medals? How about we like enter a race and get another medal? So Race for the Vaccine was mid-March, and Mustafa's mom came out for his event. Wow. Were you in a race?
Really?
Amazing. Was mom there?
Mom was there.
And she goes, go, Mustafa, go. Go, Mustafa, go. It's all about thinking outside the box, right? And doing the best you can with what you have. And we're hoping to get back to the old, but we're reinventing, like, what can we do now?
Soon as COVID started, I was not allowed to work. At the start, I wanted to give up, and I kind of did give up. I was sad. I really wanted to work, and because I wasn't allowed to, I got a little bit mad. There was other opportunities that came up, and I took those opportunities with full arms, and some of those opportunities was getting involved with the Christian Horizons Advocacy Group. I just feel that people need to be heard and they need to have a voice. And if people don't get involved, they're not gonna have that voice. And I felt that I needed to get up and get my voice heard. I felt excited. It encouraged me to continue on and not kind of be down and out like I was. I had to pull myself up and go again, and that helped me.
Well, before COVID happened, I was in a shelter, I was going to school. The pandemic started and everything just kind of cut off. I had some difficulties with taking care of her, and she had to go into Children's Aid Care. If I didn't get a place within the 2 weeks, Children's Aid would put her up for adoption. It was harder because once I get to the end point of the place, well, now they're saying that it's not available because of COVID. And it was like, oh my, like, where am I gonna stay? It was very stressful. Like, I didn't know what to do. I was like, I really need my daughter. I went to the urgent response table and they were like, okay, Christian Horizons will allow you to come in. And I was like, thank God, like, you know, like, God had answered my prayers. They gave me my own 2-bedroom apartment. They made sure that everything was okay with Children's Aid. Like, I'm very thankful. If it wasn't for them, I wouldn't have my daughter, you know what I mean? I love to see that her graduate from school, go to college, grow up to become a responsible, mature young lady. It felt like I accomplished something big, you know? I did something with myself instead of me just always saying that, oh, I can't do it, I can't do it, when I really can.
A teenager.
When he said, I felt like a teenager, I got a little emotional because if you work with Fraser any amount of time, his loss of his mobility has been just a very difficult reality for him. The things that he is not happy about in his life, we were able to use this tool to give, not only give him hope, but actively have him experiencing hope.
The ability to video chat was definitely something that has really given him hope during this pandemic.
I knew that she was gonna come back into my care, and I just had to have hope, you know? I just had to think positive. I've learned that no matter how hard it is, you still gotta pull through.
Hope for me means hold on, pain ends. Pain does end. It doesn't go on forever. It might seem like it, but it doesn't. It's a tough, tough thing for me to think about, but I know it's true. So this tattoo says, my story isn't over. It's a semicolon and it's in a butterfly. It's a lot of hope. In a sentence, a semicolon means you could have ended the sentence, but you carried it on. And I carried on.
These are excellent examples of our hope for a better future that drives our work. It is our hope for a world where everybody is valued, contributes, and experiences belonging that shapes our planning and our action for a better tomorrow. As part of our outcome-based community planning, we work together with you who use our services, you, their family members, and you, our employees, to develop four outcomes that guide our work. You can see those on our slide. To achieve these results, we have been working diligently to complete five specific strategic projects: independent facilitated personal planning, individualized funding, array of services, positive and effective leadership, recruitment, and retention. And I'm going to highlight two examples of people self-directing their lives and experiencing growth and development. For a person to control the outcomes of their lives, it's important for those around them to listen to their voices. Jeff is going to tell his story now in promoting self-advocacy here in the Central East District through Our Voices Matter. Jeff, can you share with us what you've been working on?
Yeah. So aside from co-hosting with you, I'm also here representing Our Voices Matters. I was looking for a way to help people express themselves and have their voices heard. And they were able to start the group, Our Voices Matters. I've had the honor of being the chairperson for over a year. And this last year, I learned a lot of items that came up. One of the things that we were able to do was deliver sway bags to the houses that had new people moving in, and to let them know that they were welcome here. I couldn't have done this alone, however, I want to honor two of the program managers, Paul Smith from Durham 12 and 20, Shanaz Thomas from Durham 18, for their hard work to helping to make this group happen. I also want to mention Joyce Brown from Durham 9 and Elizabeth from Codex 7, and as well as five reps in their district. They are Andrew Grant and Josh Bell from Durham, Carl Smith, that's going to be up an award later on, from Colbert, Wayne Vinn and Ron Lucas from Peterborough. Together, we're working hard to help advocate for people at Christian Horizons. Thank you, Paul, for giving me the chance to share. I can do it anytime.
Thank you, Jeff. Another way that we ensure we hear the voices of those who use our services is through our work in independent, facilitated personal planning. If you look closely at the Ministry of Children, Community, and Social Services plan, you will see that they also see the importance of that type of planning. And it's our desire to support people to create plans based on what matters most to them. So this past year, we decided to ensure that each person has the opportunity for a COVID check-in. And during these conversations, people can answer such questions as, what is important to you? What has been hard about this year? And what do you want more of in your life? In our district, we trained 3 facilitators and we utilized a summer student funded through the Canada Summer Jobs Program to complete those COVID check-ins. These 4 employees accomplished 118 check-ins by August 31st, and it's their plan to complete all 260 by the end of March. We're looking forward to seeing what this planning looks like beyond the pandemic. It has been great to hear about the stories arising out of these check-ins. For example, the story of Joshua. A few years ago, Joshua started to attend adult high school to get his diploma. And just before COVID-19 hit, he completed his first course. He was in the process of completing the second course when everything was shut down because of COVID-19. Joshua was very determined to continue his education, so he kept making inquiries and talking about when he could return back to school. He also shared his enthusiasm during his COVID check-in, where he mentioned that he wanted to go back and start his online classes, but he needed a laptop. The staff who support him contacted Christian Horizons IT department, and they were able to find Joshua a laptop. Unfortunately for him, he has received that laptop and he's now using it for his online courses. Joshua plans to further his education by becoming a chef. If we had more time, I'd share more stories, stories of people choosing new places to live, stories of people living more independently than they ever have before, stories of people voting, and even a story of someone getting engaged. We want to congratulate Sean and Emily, and we wish you all the best for the future. These stories of people in our district here in Ontario, but we also strive for a better tomorrow in 6 other countries around the world. And I would like to welcome Mark Wallace, Director of Organizational Culture and International Partnerships, as he presents a CH Global update.
Hi, everyone. If you're like me, you've been at home a lot during last year, a lot more than you probably had planned to be. But I also want to talk to you about, in my home, there's a place where we keep precious and valuable things. I'm not talking about a safe or a jewelry box, but this precious cache of treasures, this treasure trove in my house, is in fact on display. It's in the heart of our house, which is our kitchen. I'm talking about our fridge. You may think that sounds a little strange, but our fridge is where we keep precious things. There are works of art on my fridge that were done by my most beloved artists. Right now, my nephew and my son's works are displayed there. There's correspondence from people far away, birthday greetings and all those sorts of things. There's schedules that tell us when football practice is and when it's my night to make dinner. And right in the middle of it is a picture of Maynor Salvador Juarez. On your screen there, the slide we're sharing is actually a picture of a picture on my fridge. That's a picture of Maynor. And every year for the last 10 years, we've received a new picture for Maynor and we've replaced that picture because Maynor is the boy that my family sponsors in Guatemala. We've watched him grow from a 6-year-old boy to now a young man. Our kids have known who he is. In fact, at many times, his artwork was right there alongside our kids' artwork as he sent us that yearly letter from Guatemala. We've prayed for him and supported him. As Canadians, We keep our precious things on our fridge. We keep our hearts on our fridges. Every year as we get that update about how he's doing in school, and I will tell you, Maynor is not an academic. He has some learning disabilities that make school really challenging for him, but he has some specialized care at school. But knowing that if he wasn't sponsored, he would have left school a long time ago, and he would have just entered the workforce, and he would have missed out on all those years with his peers in his school. It's given us a chance to hear about his likes and his dislikes, and to see the intervention that's happened in his village as the school has grown, as things have changed. His parents did not have a chance to learn to read or go to school. Maynor did, and Maynor now can read. And so can his siblings who are coming up after him in school. Maynor and his picture on our fridge are a little window into the wider world for us and our family. Now, because I have a role within Christian Horizons Global, I also get to travel and visit, and I've met hundreds and hundreds of kids that are sponsored all around the world, and I thank our sponsors for doing that. And I know that whenever tragedy strikes, that the ongoing support of sponsorship is a huge source of comfort and relief and hope in action for the children in our sponsorship program. This past year has been a rough year in every community where we serve. In addition to COVID, there's been another crisis in every country, whether it be political unrest, earthquakes, droughts, flooding. And during that time, our in-country leaders and our local supports are always telling us about the sponsor kids are doing okay, the support is there. It's just that ongoing support that's needed as they reach out to the rest of their community. If you're like me too, we'll watch the news over this past year, and it's hard to watch sometimes. There's so much bad news hitting us, and sometimes we feel helpless. Sometimes we feel, what could I do? So I want to tell you three things that you can do to put hope in action today. One, I want to tell you a little bit about our intervention in Haiti. In Haiti, currently, we are responding to the earthquake and then the tropical storm that hit a month ago. Our local in-country church partners are reaching out to those in their community to provide emergency food and shelter to 250 families. There's a QR code on the slide there if you want to take a little picture of it that can take you right to a place where you can donate and give hope today. So that's one way you can help. The second is through our COVID Nutrition Fund. For Maynor's village, the village itself was closed and locked down just as we experienced lockdowns, which meant the people in the community could not sell their crops outside their community at different parts this year. That has created an economic crisis there, and that's happened everywhere. Inflation has raised the prices of things. Supply chains being broken down make it difficult to move goods around. Everyone is feeling the economic pinch around the world. And in Uganda, one of our leaders I talked to this last week was telling us that these funds are extremely needed at this time. So if you want to click on that QR code, you can give to our COVID Nutrition Fund, which helps in all of the countries that we work in. And then finally, one of the greatest actions you can take today to put your hope in action is to get a picture of a kid on your fridge. There's room in your heart, there's room on your fridge for a sponsored child. So click on that link today and you'll be taken directly to our sponsorship page where there are children who are waiting for sponsorship. Thank you so much to all those who do sponsor. Thank you to all our donors who make this work possible. In this difficult time, you have been a lifeline. Thank you.
Thank you, Mark. We appreciate the work Christian Horizons Global is leading to support people who experience disabilities in 6 developing countries.
Hi, my name is Shauna May, and this is my Cricut. I like to do things on Cricut, like t-shirts and cards. And if you are interested, you can reach me by ShaunaMay71 at iCloud.com.
Rachel, why do you enjoy making bracelets so much? If you would like to order a one-of-a-kind bracelet, email Rachel at durham8@christianhorizons.org.
You know, instead of waiting for a good day to happen, you know, waiting around through ups and downs, you know, I just said, look.
What are you currently knitting? A sweater. What other kinds of things do you knit? Dishcloths. Scarves. Purses. Sweaters. Email Kathy to order. Durham17@christianhorizons.org.
Just as a reminder, you have all been entered into a draw to receive a bag full of items like this from these vendors and more. And we will notify the winners this coming Friday by email.
Now, please welcome Angelicia Divas, CFO, as she presents this year's financial report.
Good afternoon. 1 Thessalonians chapter 1, verse 3 says, "We remember before our God and Father your work produced by faith, your labor prompted by love, and the endurance inspired by hope in our Lord Jesus Christ." As the Chief Financial Officer and Treasurer of Christian Horizons, I have the honor of sharing our financial information at our annual general meeting and our 7 annual community meetings. At Christian Horizons, we believe that financial transparency is important as we seek to be an excellent service provider and steward of public and individual resources. I'm going to spend a few minutes reviewing the combined financial results of the Christian Horizons group of companies. The Board of Directors approved the draft audited financial statements of each of the operating companies at their board meetings in June. The summarized combined financial statements are included on pages 20 and 25 in your annual report. These reports include the approved financial results from each of our corporations. So let's begin on page 20, the statement of financial position. At March 31st, 2021, we had an excess of $23 million of cash on hand. This is far more than our typical cash balance, and was back down to a balance we would more likely expect by the end of April. We can see the corresponding increase in accounts payable and accrued liabilities balance, which further displays the temporary nature of this cash flow increase. The pandemic was at the root of much of this excess cash through delays in spending as we dealt with keeping people safe and well, as well as the positive cash flow impacts of the timing of the wage enhancement funding. Other contributors to the high cash balance and high payables balance was the timing of payroll, just simply the timing of regular payroll amounts owing. To put this into context, our typical biweekly pay is in excess of $4 million. At the end of the fiscal year, the value of our investments has exceeded $6 million. This was due to the investment portfolio recovering after the initial market shocks in the wake of COVID-19 in 2020. About midway through the page, on page 20, we will see that we have $32 million in capital assets. This is, for the most part, homes in which people who use the services of Christian Horizons may choose to live. Related to these assets, lower in the page, we see that we owe $5.7 million in long-term debt, split between amounts to portion to be repaid or renewed in the current year or in the coming year, which is shown as current, and the remainder as long-term debt. Overall, from this statement, we see that our current assets divided by our current liabilities is a ratio of 1.22. This assures us of the health and agility of our assets, which we own, and our liabilities, which we owe. On page 21 is our summarized combined statement of operations. This statement is broken down into several columns, the most relevant of which is the operating fund. Our revenue this year was $196 million. Of that amount, $161 million, or 82%, was spent on salaries and benefits for Christian Horizons employees. This is a $12 million increase in salaries and benefits in a year where, due to COVID, we had very little growth. The increase in salaries and benefits is directly due to increased compensation due to the 1% grid increase, as well as significant temporary measures. At the onset of the pandemic, we paid a non-funded shift premium due to direct support professionals of $2 per hour. In Ontario, we were later able to replace this with pandemic pay and wage enhancement pay funded by the Ontario government. This additional compensation was appreciated by our employees and continues to provide labor stability to our program. Our revenue this year in the operating fund exceeded our expenses by $156,000, or 0.08%. The line directly below this is an increase in market value in investments of $1.1 million. This gain now more than covers the loss in market value we experienced due to COVID-19, and we are grateful for the stewardship of our investment committee and our investment stewards, investment advisor in the oversight of these funds. So we now look at the column entitled Capital Fund. This column reflects our operations from our capital assets. Each year we amortize or expense a portion of these assets. In the current year, we received $2.3 million for new capital, and we expensed $3.2 million for related to capital that we already own. The net effect is a reported deficit of $930,000. It is important to remind ourselves that these assets are fully funded and that we have fund balances in the capital fund of $29 million. Lastly is the restricted fund. This fund envelopes funds received primarily for very specific projects or initiatives. The majority of these monies received in this fund are from donors. We treat the disbursement of these funds with great care to ensure that donors' wishes are honored. In the past 2 years, we have been blessed with several large estate donations totaling $1.4 million. These funds are now being invested, and the earnings provide sustainable and predictable source of funds that we will use for our non-government funded work. I would like to take a few more minutes now to discuss two matters relevant to the financial position of Christian Horizons companies. First is COVID-19. Even before the declaration of emergency related to the pandemic was announced in March 2020, Christian Horizons was fully engaged in modifying our services, supports, and business practices to protect the health and well-being of people who use our services, our employees, and the public at large. Throughout the pandemic, the governments of Ontario and Saskatchewan have been responsible funding partners. They've provided significant resources, as I noted earlier in my presentation, to ensure that we could adequately compensate employees, manage through outbreaks, and have sufficient personal protective equipment to keep people safe. We are grateful for their partnership. The pandemic highlighted to our society the essential work performed by developmental support workers and PSWs. It also highlighted the incongruous pay levels for these essential workers. We are thankful that the Ontario government is considering investment of resources to make these increases permanent, we encourage this very important decision. Second, with respect to our international work, this pandemic has highlighted for us all how connected we are. In Canada, we are fortunate to be emerging from the pandemic due to readily available vaccines and other resources. Our partner countries are not in the same position. People in these countries are still struggling, and people with disabilities in these countries are in greater need than ever. In order to make lasting change, we need ongoing partnership. Monthly giving allows us to have a predictable income stream so we can make real commitments to lasting change. Margaret Mead once wrote, "Never doubt that a small group of committed citizens can change the world. Indeed, it's the only thing that ever has." Thank you for your attention today. It has been my pleasure to share with you the financial position of the Christian Horizons group of companies, which is stable, and we thank God for this provision. Thank you.
Thank you, Angelica. As we look back on our achievements this past year, we also want to take the time to remember and honor those that have left us.
Let's take a few minutes to remember the men and women who passed away between September 2020 and August 2021.
This is not at all how we thought it was supposed to be. We had so many plans for you. We had so many dreams. And now you've gone away and left us with the memories of your smile. And nothing we can say and nothing we can do can take away the pain of losing you. But we can cry with hope. We can say goodbye with hope. 'Cause we know our goodbye is not the end. Oh, no. And we can breathe with hope. 'Cause we believe with hope. There's a place where we'll see your face again. Question more the wisdom of God's plan, but through the cloud of tears, I see the Father smile and say, "Well done." And I imagine you where you wanted most to be, seeing all your dreams come true, 'cause now you're home and now you're free. Say goodbye with hope, 'cause we know our goodbye is not the end. Oh no, and we can grieve with hope, 'cause we believe with hope. There's a place where we'll see your face again. We'll see your face again. God promised us is true. So we can cry with hope. We can say goodbye with hope. 'Cause we know our goodbye is not the end. Oh no. And we can grieve with hope. 'Cause we believe with hope. There's a place. God's grace,
Thank you for sharing that moment of remembering with us. The sadness we feel when we lose someone that we care about, it reflects how important they were to us. I hope that some of these pictures also brought precious memories back to you.
As you may know, our vision has always been that people who experience disabilities belong to communities in which their God-given gifts are valued and respected.
These past couple of years have been so very significant. Everybody has had to endure so much. So many people showed amazing support to each other. And we really could have shared excellence awards with many people using services, their families, our many employees, or our community partners. At this time, we would like to celebrate those who have gone above and beyond in their significant contributions towards this vision. Nominations came from people who use our services, employees, family members and advocates, and community members.
Every recipient of an excellent national award will be receiving a framed piece of artwork by Lisa Edmonds, who has since childhood found joy in creating paintings and crafts. Lisa's artwork is titled Belonging, Being, and Becoming. We would like now to recognize 2020-21 Excellence National Awards to our recipients in our communities. So our first recipient is Tanya Evans. I'd like to invite Jessica John to present.
Hello, everybody. Today I have the privilege of presenting this award to Tanya, who's been my coworker and my best friend. During Tanya's career with Christian Horizons, over the past 26 years, Tanya has been nothing short of amazing. In all areas of her position, she puts forth her best effort, always advocating for the people we support, focusing on their goals, desires, gifts, and strengths. After over 26 years of service, she continues to show up with a positive attitude, smile, and resilience. While working with Tanya and Curtis, Tanya taught me many valuable skills as a DSP and many life lessons. Although Tanya has worked as a DSP for most of her career in CH, she took the leap and applied for the coordinator position with Host Family a few years ago, a new role with new challenges. Although change is hard, Tanya once again adapted to the new role and her true gifting shone through. Tanya continues to grow and adapt with an ever-changing world of developmental services, as well as an ever-changing and growing company of Christian Horizons. She continues to come alongside the individuals she currently supports, showing them kindness, grace, perseverance, and resilience, and always supporting them. She also connects with the individuals she has supported in the past 26 years, as they know she truly cares for them. To give an example, an individual we supported in Curtis truly enjoyed Tanya's support and company, and Tanya was always her preferred staff. This individual still talks about Tanya daily with positive memories. Off this young lady requests to connect with Tanya, and although COVID-19 has made this a bit hard to make in-person visit possible, Tanya shows her support through video chats whenever available. This young lady's mood can change from a simple video chat with Tanya. Tanya's positive spirit and approach to life encourages the same for everyone around her. She's a beautiful person inside and out with a true servant's heart. We love you, Tanya.
Shelly Green is our next recipient, and I'd like to invite Jody Kipping to present to her.
Hi, everyone. This award goes to Shelly Green, who has been an unrelenting support prior to and all throughout COVID, not only to the people we support, but to the employees and families as well. She has often sacrificed her own time for an hour at her desk at home to assist others and provide her wealth of knowledge in any way she can, or just to provide a listening ear. Her positivity, caring personality, compassion, and willingness to help however she can are just a few reasons for this nomination. She often goes over and above to help however she can and shies away from recognition for the assistance. Shelly is simply an honor to work with and an exceptional person. Congratulations, Shelly. You more than deserve this.
Albert Mueller, and here's 22%.
We're experiencing a little bit of technical difficulty, so I'm going to read Tony's presentation. We all have heard the phrase, all hands on deck, which sums Albert up perfectly. It does not matter the situation, Albert is always willing to help. For instance, one of our locations had an outbreak during this pandemic period. Staffing was an issue. No one was able to stay and work, but guess what? An angel by the name of Albert came to our rescue. One phone call was made and Albert did not even think for a second. He immediately asked, when can I start? no hesitation. He started working the next morning. New home, new team, new people. His energy, willingness, and time given to the people supported was beyond expectation. His action in this situation is an act of selflessness that needs to be acknowledged. This was not a one-time event either. Albert has been redeployed on few occasions to help in outbreak situations within the district and outside of the district. Albert's contribution towards Christian Horizons has been so appreciated, and we wanted to be able to recognize this publicly. Thank you, Albert, for all that you do. Our next recipient is Alana Olasoff, and presenting is Patricia Jones.
Hi. Alana is receiving this award because she has been a strong advocate for herself for many years, including the 10 plus years that she's lived at Christian Horizons. Alana had her cat, Emma, recognized as a service animal. She advocated for herself with the Durham Public Transit, and she was the first person in the Durham region to have her service cat allowed to ride the public transit with her. Alana lives independently and will advocate for herself and her rights for her apartment. Alana will determine who supports her and will advocate for her supports from the staff who she trusts and is comfortable with. Alana and I often joke that this might cause me more work, but she does not care. She's just going to advocate for herself. Alana wants to do things on her own as independently as possible. She advocates for herself and others wherever she goes, and she is waiting for the day that she doesn't have to advocate so strongly for people with disabilities because they are treated equally wherever they go.
Christine Ramble, and on behalf of the team at COVID-3, it is carried to present.
Hi, everyone. It is my honor to present Christine Womble the Excellence Award. I think she goes above and beyond in caring for the people that she has supported for the past 25 years. Chris is always there to support new staff and hires when needed and does not hesitate to step in and support her coworkers. She makes the house she works at a fun and festive place for all to be enjoying. By decorating the place, doing arts and crafts with clients, and create an exceptionally festive environment for birthdays and special occasions. Chris has also taken some of the people she supports on different vacations and camping trips, even under extenuating circumstances. Chris always makes things happen, even if that means coming in on her days off or working extra and staying longer on her shifts. She never gives up by making special moments possible, even when it seems too difficult or not possible. Whoops. Chris always makes things happen. On one New Year's Eve, she brought supplies in from her home and her house to make this day special. She had brought in a festive tie for a gentleman we supported, streamers for the house, sparkling champagne, which was of course non-alcoholic, and champagne glasses. Watching all the people we support cheer, laugh, and dance were experiences and memories remembered by all. This is why we, Coburg 3 and Maplewood staff, would like to give our most sincere thanks and gratitude to Chris. She is an example for all of us, how to truly give from the heart.
We'd like to present an excellence award to Shauna May, and presenting will be Christine Jarris.
Shauna May is definitely a most inspirational person that I know. This past year has been difficult for so many of us. Shauna May had a lot of challenges this past year, but she demonstrated great resiliency as well as the ability to advocate for herself throughout this. Through her struggles, she also discovered a new talent with using the Cricut machine. She has demonstrated creativity, skill, and has taken this new skill to the next level and is teaching others how to use this machine. She has shared her story and love for her newfound Cricut skills, and she also was highlighted in our bright spots at our host family forum. She also assisted in creating a video clip of her story. This is an amazing young lady that I really am proud to say she deserves this excellence award.
Sarah Trolley, and here's Carla, who will be presenting to Sarah today.
My name is Carla Vance. I want to thank everyone for coming out to celebrate people that are getting awards today. I nominate Sarah Trolley for an award, as she has gone over and beyond her duties as a manager. I've known her for 12 years. She has done a lot for me by getting me my own apartment in the basement, helping me grow into a woman that does not need parents anymore. She has advocated for me and takes time each day to talk to me about my day. I'm so glad to know you, Sarah, and I want to thank you for being there for me, helping me grow into a woman that I am today. I couldn't ask for a more caring and honorable manager. Thanks again, Sarah. Woo!
We're going to welcome back Jessica as she presents the next award to Peggy Pettifer-Jones.
I'm ready again. Today I have the privilege of presenting this award to Peggy. Anyone who knows Peggy knows that she is a heart of gold. Her strong leadership skills are second to none, and she truly cares about the people she supports and her teams of staff, past and present, and as well her co-workers and leadership. Peggy has been serving with Christian Horizons for over 30 years, working as a program manager for most of her career. She has shown resilience time and time again, giving the most challenging homes to support. Peggy's positive attitude and approach allows staff and individuals to be themselves, to grow, and to challenge themselves for greater opportunities. Peggy has greatly influenced my personal career as Christian Horizons, mentoring me as a DSP, team lead, and now program manager. No matter how busy Peg is, she always makes time to support her team of staff, past and present. Peggy also continually advocates for the people she supports, past and present. She's been required to advocate for the individuals she supports through Christian Horizons, but also through the ministry, behavior therapists, doctors, family members. Although this can be very rewarding, can also be very challenging. She communicates with kindness, grace, and while consistently showing up with people she supports. She is resilient beyond compare, a true inspiration, and a leader to appreciate.
Joel LaVoy and Christine Jers is back to present.
Thank you. I have had the privilege of getting to know Joan a bit. Joan is a true advocate. She demonstrates great skill in advocating for her needs and having others listen to her voice. She advocates for others in her home, and she has also faced a lot of challenges this year. She has overcome so much and continues to face challenges with a positive attitude and continues to try even when she's put in very difficult situations. Joan truly is a great recipient for this award. Thank you.
Our last award goes to Guido Cotone, and I get the pleasure of presenting this to Guido today. Guido quietly works in the background as our community facilities specialist here at the district office. And Guido, throughout the pandemic, has ensured that all support locations, every needed facility needs that they've had, that they've been met. He has also led a major renovation project, and that enables a person from the provincial waitlist to be able to move in and feel comfortable in his home. He also accomplished this while also ensuring the safety and well-being of the people using her services and her staff, as he directed contractors and inspectors. And lastly, one of the things that I was impressed with Guido about this past year is that he was incredibly quick to respond to any request that anyone would have had of him. And it's a pleasure to give this award to Guido.
Congratulations to my friend Colonel Smith. Sir Brown is coming to present.
Thank you, Jody.
It's working. We can hear you, Sherry.
Oh, can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay. You can't see me though, eh? No?
I can see you.
Oh, okay. Okay, great. Well, anyway, I have the privilege of presenting this to Carl. During COVID, Carl connected with his neighbors and he got to know them and started snow shoveling for two neighbors. This led to a connection and a relationship, which led to a paid job for Carl. The neighbors have already asked him about this coming winter. Carl initiated this on his own and keeping with all the COVID safety precautions. Carl always wore his mask and shield and did really well at social distancing. Throughout this challenging time, Carl has shown resilience and kindness to others. He has continued to work independently at his paper route, earn independent community time. Carl has a goal of saving money from his jobs and was able to purchase a Nintendo Switch. And he just opened his own bank account, savings account. Carl's determination and resiliency are remarkable. He is a strong self-advocate, and we are very pleased to nominate him or to give him this Excellence in Action Award.
Okay, our last recipient is Tashana Klein. And thank you again to Sherry for presenting.
Okay. Again, I have the absolute privilege of presenting to Tashana on behalf of the Coburg Manager team. Tashana just has stepped in very uncertain times and met an extreme need in the Coburg area for the midnight supports at several locations. Tashana's willingness to go wherever the need was and at times on very short notice was outstanding. Not only did she fill in emergencies, but also remained a support to all those teams like on a regular basis following. She still maintains her existing contract at Bagot Street while doing all of that as well. Tashana, when she was at the other programs, also used her gifts of organization, attention to detail, and cleanliness to improve the homes for the people who use our services. This type of support is so appreciated by the entire Coburg area. They have expressed endless praise and gratitude of Tashana filling that need.
We'd like to say thank you again to each recipient of our Excellence in Action Awards. We're very proud of you, and we thank you for the amazing examples that you've presented to us of hope and action during this past year. Thank you for inspiring joy and hope in the others around you. And thank you very much for all that you do.
I would like to introduce the CEO of Chris Horizons. Please welcome Janet Noel Annabelle.
Hi, everybody.
It's great to be with you. It's kind of fun because presenting from here, I actually don't know when I was on, so someone had to cue me. So I apologize if I jumped in there too quickly. Folks, before we start, I would love it if you would turn your video on. I know some of you are on and I can see your wonderful faces, but it'd be great if everybody could turn their video on so just we could be together to celebrate this awesome time of our Central East District annual community meeting. I'm so glad to be here with you. First of all, before I launch into my very long, like, I think we got about an hour, right, Paul? I'm just kidding. I just have a couple words to share with you. But before I do, I want to say first a few thank yous. Jeff and Paul, what a terrific job you've done hosting us today. Can we give them a round of applause? Collectively? Awesome. Jeff, Paul, I am just so glad that you are our hosts for our first annual community meeting because you have set the bar very high and everybody is going to have to be as good as you in these next couple of weeks. Tasha, so glad that you could join us from our partners at the Ministry of Children and Community Social Services here in Ontario. We value our relationship with government and our partners, certainly in your ministry and as a program supervisor, very, very much. And thank you for your kind words. We couldn't have got through this last year and a half without you and your colleagues. So thank you so much. And thank you for being with us today. It's fun because you watch sort of everybody on the screen. And Tasha, I watched your face when you were presenting some of the awards and you were glued to your screen because you were so excited to hear those stories. So thank you for doing that. I want to say thank you to Rick Elliott, our board chair. What a lovely message. It's so important for our teams and people who use our services to know we are governed by a volunteer group of people who give countless hours to support the Ministry of Christian Horizons. And Rick just assumed the role of chair this year. And he is just such an incredible man. I'm so glad that he could be with us today by video to share his kind and encouraging words. Mark, what a great message about our work in CH Global. I forget about the fridge. The fridge is a central part of the fridge. We go there many, many times a day, but it's a central part of our home where you're right. That's where we put the things that are closest to our heart. And my sponsor children from Haiti, Valentina and Tomas, I just got a new picture. So I'm going to put those up on my fridge when I go home tonight. Thanks for that reminder. And how cool is that QR code? I actually tried it out. I don't know if anybody did, but it takes you right to those pages. Technology just blows my mind and I was pretty impressed with that. So thanks for that. Angelica, thank you again for your, not just your presentation. I mean, that's awesome, but your leadership of managing our financial resources is so important, never more so than these days of COVID-19. And Angelica and her team in our finance department, they do just a fabulous job making sure that we're spending the right amount of money on the right people for the right objectives. And Angelica, we really appreciate your leadership. And wow, there were 29 nominations for Excellence Awards in this district. That alone is something to celebrate. What an incredible group of people and 12 winners. I think that's right, yeah, 12 winners. That was just inspiring. And how fun was it to have people presenting in real time? Tony, I'm sorry the mute button didn't work, but your words were really beautiful and really appreciated your comments as well as everybody else's. So incredible. And Alana, a service cat. I love it. I think that that is very innovative and I'm really glad that that worked out for you. I'd be remiss if I didn't mention Jessica. As a mom myself, managing work and home and being on parental leave and contributing and all the things that Jessica was managing there in that moment, to hear her speak with such eloquence about not only one, but two award winners, that was fantastic. And Jessica, I hope you're having a wonderful parental leave and I can't wait for you to come back and join us at Christian Horizons. Thank you for being a part of our time today. Last but not least, before I share a couple of words that I've prepared for you, I don't know if you've had a chance to look at our annual report. Our team in communications just did a fabulous job putting it together today or this year. And our annual report is a look back over the last fiscal year. So for the year 2020 and 21, it's a compilation of stories and it talks about some of the things that we're moving towards within our strategic plan. It certainly has a very important financial report. But on page 18, if you have it with you, please turn to it. It talks about employee milestones. And it is incredible to see the tenure of people at Christian Horizons celebrating 20, 25 years, 30 years, and even a few 35-year anniversaries this year. Here in Central East, Carmen and Shamil are celebrating 30th anniversaries with Christian Horizons. That is just phenomenal, and I want to thank you for your commitment to this organization and the work that you do every day. I'd like to note all of the milestone anniversaries, but we would be here for an extra hour, so I won't do that. But have a look and think about those people and how you've had the opportunity and the good fortune to interact with them. So, as you know, we're here to celebrate year 2020-2021. That's right, 2020-2021. And celebrate, that's kind of a difficult word for us to use this year. It's been a really hard time for everyone, not just because of the pandemic, but so many other hard issues have happened over this past year. The racism in our society has been given voice through the Black Lives Matter movement. This summer's discoveries of thousands of unmarked graves at the former residential schools where Indigenous people were forced to attend. And this pandemic just goes on and on and on. 9 people connected to Christian Horizons, 2 employees and 7 people who use our services have died due to COVID-19. Globally, I think we've just hit the marker of 5 million people have left the world because of COVID-19. It's incredibly tragic. What's also tragic though, is the fear and anxiety that have grown to dominate communities. It is very hard for everyone. We see incredibly positive stories, ones we've heard today, about people taking care of people, sometimes people they don't even know. We also see a lot of stories of anger and rage. I continue to be so proud of our employees who have worked very hard to get through this year and a half. At all parts of the organization, whether it's the team who've been creating protocols to ensure that Christian Horizons employees are fully in line with government regulations and directives, or the teams in IT or human resources who are managing data or coming up with innovative ways to recruit new employees. And of course, our teams at the front line, wearing personal protective equipment for sometimes up to 12 hours a day, day after day after day, managing outbreaks and supporting people despite severe isolation and being separated from their families and loved ones, are having some pretty good days. This effort and achievement is worth celebrating. I want to seriously thank each one of you, whatever your role has been, for what you've contributed to this effort so far. And I mean our employees, the people who use our services, and their families and loved ones. Each of you have played an integral role. And on behalf of our board and on our membership, I want to be sure that you know how valued you are. Sometimes, as I prepare to speak, I look back over past speaking notes, and I actually keep every one of them. And it's been 10 years since I stepped into the role as Chief Executive Officer. 10 years of annual general meetings, and over these past years, many years of annual community meetings, coming together to think about the year that has passed, and together, looking forward to the future. 10 years of celebrating employees' long-term commitment to this ministry, 10 years of recognizing the excellent and incredible contributions of the people who use our services, employees, business owners, community partners, and friends. A lot's happened in these 10 years. Throughout this time, we've often talked about our reason versus our right to exist as a Christian organization. We've talked about the fact that we do have a legal right to exist within Canadian law, but that's fairly meaningless without our reason to exist. How is a community better because Christian Horizons is there? What is it that we believe about Jesus Christ that helps people and their families, that demonstrates value to taxpayers and donors throughout Canada, that contributes to better communities and helps governments ensure that people with disabilities have really good lives? There's no question that we have rights, but we also need to think about our responsibilities, our reason, what is better for people because of the efforts of Christian Horizons. You know, the Apostle Paul writes in his letter to the Philippians, "Do nothing out of selfish ambition or vain conceit. Rather, in humility, value others above yourselves, not looking to your own interests, but each of you to the interests of others." There's no shortage of pain and sadness out there, no shortage of difficulty. And as we walk through the coming months and coming possibly years of this pandemic, there'll be no shortage of opportunity to show a watching world what we at Christian Horizons stand for. As we fully lean into promoting communities where everybody belongs, let's do it with kindness, with strength, with purpose, and with insight. I continue to see all of these characteristics in our teams at Christian Horizons. I wish I knew that when this would all be over, but I do know that if we keep on focusing on caring for each other, we will get through these difficult days. Please look out for the well-being of others. Encourage our government and our public service leaders and do whatever it is we have the strength to do tomorrow, next week, or next month. Hope in action. I love it. That's our theme. What a wonderful theme it is. Hope not just for tomorrow, but hope in action today. I think that it's a key for all of us. Let's be active in our hope. Let's help others. Let's take action that is not about our own personal benefit, but to benefit of the benefit of others, those we love, those we care about, and heck, maybe even people we don't even know. And once we're through all this, I can only imagine how energized all of us will be together to build, to create, to advocate, to see communities filled up with people who are recognized for their contributions and their gifts, a community where everybody belongs. Thanks for being together today. It's been a joy to be with you celebrating. God bless.
Thank you, Janet. We also thank you for your leadership this past year. So we have now come to the end of our time together and just wanted to thank each and every one of you for joining us. It's been a pleasure to share these memories and celebration with you. I hope that together we can continue to discover big and small ways to take action toward our vision of belonging, where people accomplish their goals and dreams and grow in relationships with the people and communities that matter most to them. We're thankful that you chose to be a part of this reflection and celebration with us today of our 2020-2021 year. We hope that you have been encouraged by the examples of hope and action shared in our Onward video, as well as the incredible stories and examples in our Excellence in Action recipients.
We hope that today brought us some joy and encouragement. And we want to thank you for being here. Remember, everyone who attended today's celebration has been entered in a draw. One of our Hope and Action sway bags. Winners will be announced on Friday, so keep an eye on your email.
One last thank you, and that's to Jeff. Jeff, it's been wonderful co-chairing with you today. We hope that you enjoyed yourselves and that you have a great rest of your day. And if you please join me in prayer. Heavenly Father, we thank you that you've been with us today. Father, this past year has been significantly difficult at times, but through it all, we have seen your hand at work, and we've seen what you have accomplished through us in the lives of the people around us and out into our communities as well. And as we step out into this new year, we just pray that you would continue to be with us, continue to give us wisdom and the strength to do your work so that every person in our communities can be valued and respected and use the gifts that they have to contribute. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.